This episode of DNews is brought to you by Pacifico Beer. Sharks. We can't live with them, but we also can't live without them. So why are sharks continuing to disappear, and how can we stop it? Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and it's Shark Week here at Discovery, which means that all week long we are going to be bringing you awesome stories, facts, anything interesting relating to sharks. They are the ocean's greatest predators, after all, but they still don't hold a candle to humans, and thanks to us, they are disappearing in vast numbers. According to a study published this January, almost a quarter of the world's cartilaginous fish, mostly sharks and rays, will be facing extinction within the next few decades. So what's causing this? Well, like I said before, it's mostly our fault. Overfishing is a huge problem globally, and in the past couple decades alone, the demand for sharks has gone way up. People hunt them for their meat, fins, cartilage, liver, skin, and teeth, and they often die in brutal, inhumane ways. Shark fin soup, for example, is a delicacy in many Asian countries, and it's typically harvested through a process called shark finning, where fishermen cuts off the fins of the shark and tosses it back into the ocean afterwards to die. It is a horrible practice that kills anywhere from 75 to 100 million sharks every single year, and many countries are starting to crack down on it. In December 2013, China banned shark fin soup from all official banquets, but it's by no means difficult to find anywhere in Southeast Asia. I was in Singapore last summer, and I unwittingly ate a bowl before I knew what it was. And on a personal note, not that great. It just tastes like a fishy egg drop soup. Although I'm told that the flavor isn't what makes it a delicacy, it's the fact that it's so expensive, so it's more of a status symbol than anything else. Obviously, no animal should have to suffer though, just so we can feel important about ourselves, but this is just one of the many ways we've been destroying these populations en masse. And compared to other marine life, sharks have been the most radically affected by fishing. Part of that has to do with their biology. They're at the top of the marine food pyramid, so there are way fewer sharks than other kinds of animals in the ocean. They also have extremely long lifespans. Some females take up to 10 years to reach sexual maturity, and they may only produce a few hundred pups in a lifetime, so their reproductive rates are pretty low. Adding to that is the fact that millions of sharks are killed every year by fisheries that don't even hunt sharks. They just happen to get caught up in the nets. Now you might be wondering, what impact does this have on us? We don't live in the ocean, so why should we care? Well, shark conservation doesn't just protect sharks. It also protects other things like coral reefs, which are currently being destroyed by the effects of overfishing. A reduction in the number of sharks leads to an increase in mid-level predators, which in turn leads to a decrease in the number of herbivorous fish. Herbivorous fish are what eats the algae that grows on reefs, so without them, the reefs get overwhelmed by algae and they die. Much like land, what's beneath the ocean abides by a very delicate life cycle, and disturbance to any part of that cycle can disrupt the entire balance. So what can we do about it, short of lobbying our local lawmakers? Well, that is one way to handle it, but you can also take matters into your own hands. You can spread the word on social media, organize local campaigns, or donate directly to shark conservation charities. Conservation International is one such organization where you can donate $75 to protect one square mile of the ocean from the devastating effects of fishing. There are tons of other websites out there with many more suggestions on ways to get involved, so if you're interested, go check out some of the links that we've included in the description below. And if all this talk of the ocean has you clamoring to travel the world, then you're in luck. Pacifico just launched a new campaign that lets you experience the world around you from the comfort of your home computer. Underneath every Pacifico bottle cap, you'll find GPS coordinates to one of 21 amazing locations throughout Baja, Mexico, and the US West Coast. So the next time you crack one open, just hit up discoverpacifico.com on your mobile phone or desktop computer, enter the GPS coordinates, and from there you can watch a 1 to 2 minute video highlighting what makes each of those spots truly incredible. Plus, beer. Who doesn't like that? In the meantime, if you guys have any recommendations on shark conservation charities or ways to get involved, just leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching and happy Shark Week.